Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. Welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how to approach the arrow questions on the USMLE. Now, these questions can be really confusing, right? Because you're gonna have up arrows, down arrows, sometimes no change. And this strategy will allow you to get these questions correct and also spend less time during your block. So let's get into the first step. The first step I say is predict your response prior to going into your answer choices. As you can see on many of these questions, there's just going to be a sea of arrows in the answer choices, right? So before you attack A, B, C, D, think in your mind, what do you expect to go up? What do you expect to go down? So prediction is going to be very helpful. The second step is going to be starting with the arrow that you know the most. For example, if I give you a up-down arrow question about heart failure, well, in heart failure, you know that cardiac output is going to be low. So start with the parameter that you know the most. The third step is going to be eliminate the answer choices based on one arrow being wrong. Well, going back to our question about the patient with heart failure having low cardiac output, you know that the other arrow questions or the other arrow answer choices that have high cardiac output, that's probably going to be wrong. And so you need to eliminate those other arrows based on just one arrow of the whole thing being wrong. And then finally, if you come to a parameter or an arrow that you're not sure of, use the other arrows to help you. Let's go back to that question. Say that you have a patient who has heart failure. We already said that the cardiac output's going to be low, but say you didn't know what the end diastolic volume would be. Well, remember in heart failure, you are going to have low cardiac output. And if you double down on the physiology, cardiac output is stroke volume times heart rate. And stroke volume is going to be a function of end diastolic volume minus end systolic volume. And if you are going to integrate somebody with a failing heart, well, they're not going to be able to squeeze that diastolic volume out because they have a bad stroke volume. And subsequently, you're going to recognize that their end diastolic volume is going to be up. And so as you see, this strategy means that you are going to take other arrows that you know are correct, focus on the physiology, and then integrate the arrows that you're not sure of, okay? So this strategy, very important. Predict your response prior to going to the answer choices. Start with the arrow that you know. The arrows that are totally wrong, eliminate the whole answer choice. And then finally, the arrows you're not sure of, look at the physiology, look at the other arrows that you are sure of to figure out the unsure arrows.